It's Sunday, soul food day. I'm gonna teach you motherfuckers how to make some soul food. Them niggas tired of box macaroni and cheese. They tired of chicken nuggets. Them niggas want soul food meals. I'm gonna teach you bitches how to make a soul food meal. We're gonna do fried chicken. We're gonna do baked macaroni and cheese. We're gonna do collard greens with turkey necks. No swine for me. No pork and fork. And we're gonna do yams. Okay? Bear with me. It's a bitch first time. Cooking with Don't Call Me White Girl. Right here we have boiling water because to make the collard greens, we have to cook the meat. I use turkey neck. If you do like pork, if you fuck with that swine and your arteries are all fucked up, your heart disease and whatever, that's it. No judgment here. I do turkey neck for my collard greens. So I'm gonna clean my meat, normal shit, rinse it off, and I'm gonna boil it for like 40 minutes. It's really up to you. It's smoked meat. We're doing smoked turkey necks. Now at the end, we're gonna add it in and put out all the ingredients, but smoked turkey necks are already cooked, so when you boil them, you're not necessarily cooking it, you just want the flavor to get in your water. That's the whole point. You want that flavor to be absorbed in your greens, so your greens not dry and nasty like your aunt's are. Let me rinse the meat. We always gotta clean the meat. Clean the meat. Nothing crazy. Throw them right on in there with the top. So we're gonna cook this for about 45 minutes, okay? Y'all just gotta keep up. Pause the video, start the video, cause a bitch is gonna just keep going. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time waiting for this, waiting for that. My pasta's already done for my baked macaroni and cheese. I use simple elbow macaroni, nothing crazy. I only use two cheeses for my macaroni and cheese. I use American and I use cheddar. It's important on how you slice those cheeses. Very important on how you cut your cheese. The major thing is you want blocks. So just to give you an example, I'm cutting it about this thick. I don't have no fucking inches. Use your brain. We got like this, we're gonna cut that into four. Cutting that into four creates a cube. That's what you want. You could do cubes smaller, but you don't want shred. So if the shredded cheese on sale, don't get the fucking shredded cheese. You need this block because you need this cube for it to melt correctly. Baked macaroni and cheese is a casserole. Us Negroes, we don't usually make casseroles. This is a big casserole. That's all this is. Just like those weird casseroles at the employee dinner, except for this is a good one, okay? Cube cheese, that's the whole thing. Now, a fast way, you just slice it through. That's my phone, chill. It's probably my baby father. We gonna ignore that. Boom. Once you get a couple cubes, right? You just stack them bitches up. Stack them the fuck up and cut them in fours. You just want squares. It's not rocket science. Don't get all weird about the cubes. Our water is still boiling with this turkey meat. Now, I season the water. The whole point of cooking this smoked turkey, because you're not actually cooking it. The whole point is to get all the flavors from the meat inside of this water. So when I do add my collard greens, it all absorbs it and it's seasoned well. The season that I use, number one, we got accent, okay? Wakes up food flavor. Then we got regular old Lori's. For years and years, generations and generations, decades and decades, niggas been seasoning with Lori's. Don't OD with the Lori's because Lori's has a distinct taste, so you don't want your greens to taste like Lori's. That's corny. That's why they never invite you to cook at the family reunion, because you fucking Lori's everything down, dog. And your shrimp tastes like Lori's. Your chicken tastes like, slow down, mommy. Switch up. Lori's is a combination of seasonings, a bunch of shit in it, so it's like easier, but it's better to just break the shit down. This is my little cousin. He retarded, so my aunt got me watching. Just see him. We gonna talk a little bit. Hey, stop drooling. Boom. I put a little minced garlic in the water as well. I do a little minced garlic. I do Lori's. I do accent, and that's about it. And again, I'm gonna just cover this and cook it. It can boil as hard as it wants to. It doesn't really matter. Like I said, the meat's already cooked. You can't overcook the meat. Also, a lot of people like eating that turkey out of the greens. It's always that one greedy bitch in the kitchen waiting on a turkey neck. It's only to season the greens, but the more you cook it, the softer it is, the easier it is to eat. Because when you serve it, it's pieces of meat in the collard greens. So it's up to you how long you cook it. My recommendation is at least 45 minutes to an hour to get that season in that water. I got my greens already soaking in water. You have to clean the greens. I use packaged greens. I use packaged greens that already came cut up. You still have to clean them. If you're using greens from the supermarket, from the produce section, it's more of a cleaning process. It could be bugs on it. You have to really soak it in salt water. That's my recommendation. If you don't clean your greens, you can taste that shit. That grit, that's nasty. Don't be a dirty bitch, clean your greens. All right, I have my yams smoking and soaking in water. Some people scrub their yams. I'm not a big scrubber because I'm going to peel them anyway. I use a regular peeler. Just get them bald. I wanted to say bald like your edges, but I'm going to stick positive right now in this moment. Get the yam nice and bald, right? Now, these yams are small because that's all they had. I went to my local market. Maybe you go to produce markets. I don't know. I've read that a bigger yam is just less work. Like, these are small, so it depends on the shape of your yam. Depends on the original shape of the yam. I do a circle shape. So I make sure I get all that peeling off of there, all of it. If there's some left, that's fine. Nothing's going to happen. You just lazy as shit. Here, we got the brand yam. We're going to bring it down and just slice straight through. Straight circles. The thicker your yam is, the longer it is for your yam to cook. I'm a mom. I got kids. I'm trying to get this shit done. So I like them sliced kind of thin. Not too thin, because when I eat yams, I want them thick. So keep in mind how you like your yams. The favorite yams you like and the shape that they use might be the shape that goes for you. Me, I just do a circle. It starts out this big and ends up half this size after baking. But again, we talking about less than half an inch thickness, because I don't want to wait long. It's up to you. The baking process is longer. Sit your slow ass down. Again, that's my, okay. Fast forward with that. He's slow, okay? Anyway, with the yams, once we have them sliced up, we're going to bake them. So we have a couple more to slice, and then we're going to put them in our aluminum foil pan for baking for later. With my yams, the simple ingredients, I'm doing regular, just butter. I do pancake syrup.
That looks good, cuz.
Pancake syrup. Hold on. Pancake syrup, butter, brown sugar, regular sugar. If you want to use vanilla extract, you can. So we're doing sugar, brown sugar, pancake syrup, and cinnamon. I don't use a lot of cinnamon because I don't fucking like it. If you like it, you can use it. You can't overdo it with cinnamon. Don't hand them yams all brown skin like that. Just keep them their natural color, that peachy color. That's how I like it. You know, you doing what I'm doing. So do what the fuck I do. I don't do a whole bunch of cinnamon. I don't like when y'all do it. You got all that big ass cold of cinnamon, and then the yams got all that brown shit on top. I don't like that shit. So that's why I don't do it like that. Sit your little ass down. Come on. Somebody call his mom. I want you to see what time his fucking mom coming to get him. What time that bus come?
Make macaroni and cheese. We already got my pasta. Like I said before, it's just regular old elbow macaroni. I got 3 eggs. I already beat them. I got my American cheese. I already sliced and showed you how to slice. If you can't remember, rewind it the fuck back, because I said that already. We got the sharp cheese, and then we got the extra sharp cheddar cheese. It's a pound to each. It's going to be some words on the bottom at some point to tell you some of that shit. Just write it down as you go. Just keep pausing. Okay. I use regular metal pans, because I'm from the hood. Let me tell y'all a little bit about me. My friends are here. Say hi, y'all. They just staring at me. Say hi. Say hi, bitch. Say hi so the people can hear you. Okay. I'm about to say your whole name on here. Like, and you know my slow cousin, he's still here, D. Say hi. Alright, I put my macaroni here. I already rinsed it off, like all that nasty pasta shit off of there. I have about a stick of butter. I kind of like play it by ear with the butter. Like if I think it's too much, so I melt a stick, but I might not pour the whole stick in here. My goal is when I put it together that it sticks, so it kind of feels a certain way on my hands. That's why I make sure I wash my hands first. So I just put my little egg in here. It don't really matter how you pour it. I pour it all around because that way I don't have to spend a bunch of time mixing it. It really don't matter how you do the cheese. None of that matters. You already got the shape, and that's the most important part. Sometimes I have extra cheese left. Like, it really go by how it looks. If it looks like it's way more cheese than pasta, then I don't use all the cheese. Why, I don't know. That's how I do shit. But I gave you the directions. You can do what the fuck you gonna do. You gotta put your own shit on it. That's the whole thing about cooking. It's not just following the recipe to the T. You do your own thing. Like, you have to follow the directions that count so it can bake right or cook right. But for the most part, it's about what you like. So I'm gonna mix the cheese around. They don't know I get foolish. All right, I kind of forgot about the milk. I use vitamin D milk, not too much, just to wet it. The whole point is to make it like a sticky kind of thing, like almost like it's holding up on its own. You don't want it to be all loose. It has to like stick a little bit. So the milk will fuck that up for you. So don't use too much milk. I hope people that watch this don't mind cussing, because I cuss. Like, I ain't ready to watch my mouth for y'all to watch me cook some shit. This is my shit, and it's good stuff. It's good food, and when you cook it, it's going to be good. So if you had to listen to me cuss, it's a virtue. It's very important that when you put this foil on top of your metal pan, that it's sealed. You want all the cheeses to melt. You want it to cook together. This is like about 45 minutes to an hour for me. My stove is set to 350. The browning is after that first initial hour. That's when I'll remove the foil just to get a nice brown on top of it, just for the look of it. Because you know damn well you don't like no light skin big macaroni. Okay, baked macaroni just slid it in the oven. I'm going to try to put my yams in at the same time. I already have my yams sliced in our little circles and cleaned off and everything. Everything is ready. We're going to pour them in. I just do a thin layer of them, like not too much. I don't have that many yams because I was cooking for my family. I don't have a big family. You know how much you need depending on how many people you cooking for, but it kind of goes by the tray. And then it depends on the size of the yam. So this was 7 or 8 yams, but they were small. So you just gotta kind of gauge some of that stuff yourself. So I just do a thin layer of yams and I just pour what I want on them. Plain sugar, and it's by eye. I try to cover them, I use a lot of sugar. You should use less sugar because sugar's bad for you. I'm not. Okay. I'm gonna do my ground cinnamon. Like I said, just a little bit because I don't like a whole bunch of that cinnamon. It changes the color of the yams, it makes it real thick, and I'm not really a big fan of that. So I got a small amount of cinnamon. I have a lot of bit of sugar. I already sliced my butter up. I use butter. That's what I use, okay? So whatever, judge me. And I'ma just throw my slices in. It's not a crazy amount of butter, but I just want it. I kind of layer it with the same stuff. My goal is to kind of bake it in, and then I try to candy them. And I don't know how to really explain that, but I'ma try to show you. Take some for you. And I'm going to wrap it tight the same way I did my macaroni and cheese because I want the yams to cook while it's in the oven. And then in like 45 minutes, I'm going to check them and see what it looks like. Okay, we're going to start the wings. I love fried chicken. It's my favorite. I'm a big fried chicken person. I just got some wings. I like smaller wings. I tried to find the smallest I could find. I'm already cleaning my wings. I got a little bit of feathers off and the skin off of it. I'm real simple with the season. I only do salt, pepper, and garlic powder. That simple. Now that we're back, we had to take an intermission because this nigga got a droid. So we had to stop everything just to redo it. Okay. Anyway, I got my chicken all seasoned.
You don't talk about your slow cousin like that.
Yeah. I got the chicken all seasoned. I like to get the flour all over chicken. Now, a lot of y'all use the plastic bags. I used to use plastic bags. It makes too much of a mess. I just use Tupperware, regular flour, nothing special. Okay, plenty of it. Lay my wings in there. It don't really matter how you lay them. Because I'm gonna shake them up. Now I don't put a lot of wings in. Now some people might put all their seasoned chicken in here with the flour and then let it sit while they're cooking. I don't like that. I feel like it makes it too thick. I don't like sitting in flour. Like you might prep it and you have it floured and you sat in the refrigerator. I think the chicken is clean, seasoned, floured, grease. If it's not gonna make it to grease, no flour should have it on it. Now it could be seasoned. But the flour needs to be like from flour to grease. And I also think that the colder the chicken, the harder it fries. That's just what I think. I don't have no fucking facts to prove that. But I like the chicken to be cold, not room temperature. It's real important in your chicken for your grease to be brand new or fairly new. Once your grease changes colors, if it has a smell to it, you want to just empty it. If you don't have a deep fryer, put it in a spaghetti pot, sis. Put in this, fill it up. And just do it like that. I don't think that chicken comes out right when you fry it in a skillet. I think it has to be deep fried. So that's what it is. So I got my deep fryer. I got it set to 365, but it's right here what it sets it to. Chicken, meat, fish. If you don't have a set in 365, around 365 is where you want to be at. I got the chicken already floured in there. The grease is ready. The green light indicative is ready to go. If you put the chicken in the grease before it's too hot, your chicken is going to suck. If your grease is too hot, your chicken's going to suck. Like, you have to have the grease right. It's real important. Just dunk it in there. It should have a nice little fry to it. I put the lid on it. My deep fryer. Back up a little bit. Sit. Get that paper towel. Get that drool. The whole time. But if you notice that they hanging up and it's a piece that's not going to cook, try to adjust it. Because you want them to be golden brown. If that's what you want.
Back
the fuck
up. I thought you were talking to me.
Okay, my greens, my meat is a little broken up. They've been cooking on the stove in the seasoned water for 3 hours now. They're soft. I season as they go. An extra season I use because I tasted the actual greens was this Goya salad and vegetable seasoning. So you could do that by taste if you don't like just the water that you use. Because your water is your water and your smoked meat is your main source of seasoning. My wings are about done. I flipped them a couple times. This is the color of mine, so I like them. It was like 10 minutes-ish, but basically when it floats to the top, then I wait for the color that I like. So I'm gonna put them here, shake them. I'm gonna let them sit for a second, and then I'm gonna put them in paper towel, okay? We're just gonna speed it up. You let yours sit a little bit in the basket. Oh shit, all right. The baked macaroni is ready. I leave mine in a little longer. You don't have to. I just like mine real brown. You can see golden brown bubbly. It's a lot of little excess butter. If you want to, you can hold it and pour some of that butter off. But that's perfect. That's my Big Mac. Okay, let's check on the yams. I'm going to just go ahead and bring the yams out because I always pour off my water. I just want them to be soft. And I add a little more sugar to candy. So I check if they're soft with a spoon, and they soft enough. Stir them up, make sure all that good old butter and cinnamon and brown sugar, all of it is in there. And then I'm gonna just pour some of that water off in an effort to candy them. We got our finished product. Got our collard greens with the turkey neck. Like I said, I like my turkey meat in the greens. We got some wings here fried hard. We got some yams. It took me about 25 minutes to candy them. You can see that glaze on them. 25 minutes because they were already soft. And of course, my favorite thing in the motherfucking world, baked macaroni and cheese, better than your baby moms and your grandmoms. Okay? We ready to eat. Y'all ready to eat? I wish you could cut to these hungry ass niggas behind you, but they don't want to be on camera. All right, so you got cooking with Don't Call Me White Girl. I'm going to come back and do something different, probably something seafoody. I want to see how y'all like this. Screen record it, put it on Facebook, throw it on the gram. Write it down, try the recipe. Share how you feel about the recipe, tag me. All my information tag below, I'm reposting everything. Just let me know what you guys feel, put in the comments what you would like to see me cook. Put in the comments if you don't fucking like it, hater. Thanks.